Hello and welcome to SolidCon 2021 Virtual Summit. My name is Michael Vinetsky. I'm a Vice President, Product Management in SolidCon. Today, I'm glad to share with you our major upgrade in SolidCon 2021, the new tooltable. We are calling it Toolkit because it's not only the simple list of CAMPART tools, as we know from previous version, it's much more. I hope this presentation will show you the power of it and all of you will enjoy this new amazing functionality. Let's get started. Before I will show you new features, I would like to talk about why we started this project and what's the target of it. The old tooltable was designed about 25 years ago and provide good solution to CNC machines in this market. But the CNC market going forward, we meet more machines with complex tooling and more non-classic tools for voice machines. We constantly improved our software by adding VMID functionality, improved simulation. The machine preview feature become a part of user workflow, but the tooltable limitations start to be a bottleneck. The old SolidCon tooltable can be a showstopper to entry to the modern Miltown and Swiss type machines world. After a lot of analyzing of customer requests and CNC machines configurations, we decide to develop this flexible and powerful solution. Here are the future request lists we targeted during this development. Flexible tool structure to support future developments. Assembly tool holder from several components. Using 3D models to define cutters. Managing components libraries and use tool manufacturers catalogs. Faster work with big tool tables. Support of multiple offsets on single tool. Multi-tool assembly support. Flexible work with live tools and angular head attachments. Clear and visual representation of tool in machine preview and tool picture. Of course, precise simulation of revolved cutters and holders to avoid collisions in machine. We have different types of toolkits. The first type is tools component libraries. This type designed to store cutters, shanks, adapters, and holders in one single interface. This library designed to use folders and each component can be linked to 3D model. I will show you how it looks in SolidCon software. I go to toolkit, right click on it, make an edit tool library, tool components, and I will open ISCAR components library. How we see in this library, we have more than 300 cutters, 99 shanks, and almost 200 adapters and holders in single library. Each cutter is divided by folders for each family separately. You can see 3D preview for each cutter, and of course, see the parameters and dimensions of cutters in interface. Also, shanks can be defined here, okay? Shanks can be different, it can be part of the holder. It can be turning chunk, so here we see cutoff shank for turning tool. It can be also adapter for turning, or adapter for milling tool. In this case is HSK family. We can see any HSK adapters what we have in this library just by clicking the component. So let's start from holder definition. So holder definition today can have multiple 3D models in single holder. It have special features as mounting definition and joints definition, also can contain axes and work with multiply components libraries. I will show another example how to use holders in SolidCon. I will open other library, tool components, and I will go to Redline has BMT65 library. Here I have only adapters, so I can go to anyone, press on tool viewer and see how the holder is designed. So we have a mounting point. This point will be used to mount the holder on the station, and we have a joint. Joint is a point where we will mount a next component. So you can manage the joint positions by pressing on connections and see the list of the joints and each joint orientation and position. So how we seen the tool assembly can use a source, a library, or designed with folders and linked, can be linked to files. And the tool assembly himself have a structure of the tree, but clearly explain us how this tool was built. I'll go to this tool. Let's go to other tool library. I will open the tool library of this compart, and let's see how this tool is looks like. We have, let's open it in tool preview, so it will be much more easy to see it. And I will go switch to focus view, and this focus view allow me to select the component and highlight it in view, so I can easy understand which component I am editing now. So I have HSK-A63 angular head adapter, I have the angular head body, and shanks, in this case is ER20 collets, and of course cutters, and I can see the two cutters mounted in opposite directions on one holder. So how we do creating assembly? First, I will show it also in SolidCAM. So let's close the current assembly and I will create a new one. I will create a new library, going to new tool library, tool assemblies. I will select the source for this assembly. It will be a Redline HasBMT65 library. Let's go here and select the holder. You can see it in preview how it looks like. I'm just double click on it and it's automatically adding it to the storage. Now I want to continue to make this assembly. I'm going to other library and select ISCAR generic tool library. In this library, in turning tool adapters, I have a config tools, and I will use this C5 right hand tool. I'll go and just drag it to this assembly, and here it looks like I can just fix the orientation by scrolling the rotation value and reverse it in the direction 180 degrees. Here's my assembly is done. Now we can use this holder for my machine, just add the cutter and start to cut. Components in assembly can be linked to the source libraries. So what it's mean in SolidCAM, let's go back to the software and see how it looks like. I will go to my tool library and see my tools, how it looks like. Some of the tools now have this marker. It said this tool is not updated and it's linked to ISCAR generic tool library. What it's mean not updated? I cannot edit these values because these values taken from the source library. In source library, this tool was changed. Maybe because we changed the supplier or we measured the tool and said, okay, it's not 6 millimeter in the real tool. So I can just update this tool and get the real tool dimension, how we see it's in the source library. Or I can keep it unupdated and use it for my compart. If I, this tool is already on the machine and I'm sure if the 6 millimeter is from previous bench or something like this. Okay. So what's the changes we have in the partool table? The partool table is similar to assemblies. So we also can have different sources to use in it. You can manage cutting points, and you can of course control by VS cutting points the tool wear and the T-cutters cutting points and make a chamfering with compensation. Let's see how it works in software. I will open my tool table, and what we see here? I can see the cutter number 11, what have appears here twice. First time 11A and second time is 11B. What means I have this cutter two cutting points. If I go to tool preview and I click to my cutting point, I will see the red dot is a pair here and red circle is around my cutter. If I go into top cutting point, this red circle will move to my top side of the cutter, and also the red point is will appear here. It's very close to coordinate system, but is where. Okay. That means this cutter have two different offsets what can be used to cut with top point and with down point. Of course, when we're talking about a new tool table, we have to talk about very important feature, what's its support of angular heads and live tools adapters. So I will open another part to show the functionality. I'll go and use my test box setup. Okay. For this part, I'm using Haas machine. It's a new generation of Haas machines. They call it UMC Duo. It's really interesting configuration, and I really like how it works. And let's see first the machine. So machine is looks like a rotary table, classic trinium table. Okay, you can see the B axis and C axis moving. And in addition to it, we have a simple V axis table for final working, like making the features and finishing the part. So let's see how this process is looks like in SolidCAM. When I go to setup, I can see my mounting positions for a part, and I will start my working from a fixed table, this one, in this wise. The second operation will be on the rotary table. Okay, I'm finishing my work here, and I need to remove the fixtures feature, and I will use my fixtures table to position. Okay. So let's mount my part in the start position and see what we're going to see here. So first I will start my simulation in machine simulation just to validate the process. Okay. So in machine simulation we can see the parts are mounted on the machine. Let's give it to load the parts, and now we're starting the machining. So first part is loaded like initial stock, a second part have a fixture feature, okay, and the last one is just removing the fixture to finish the part, and we will see how it's working. So first I will start to use my T number one is a face mill, and this tool is used on all three components, so I would like to use it without changing on all three components, and after it move to the last one. How we see, we are trying to avoid unnecessary tool changes. On this machine, it takes about 5-7 seconds. So each tool change can change the time of machining. So we're trying to reduce it to the minimum. So we see regular 5 axis and Excel working on the table. Of course, we have a rotation of the tables here and indexing of the position. I just want to stop it on particular place and show you how it works with the angular heads. So first one, I'm using here the inclined angular head to drill with drills here, okay? Because I don't have any other position possible for this drilling, so I'm using angular head. So let's see how it works. I did make it a little bit slower. Okay. And the second operation, right, I'm using angular head, is to make this undercut milling on this feature. So let's see how it works like. There is no other solution for this feature except of angular head adapter. So once this job is finished, I can continue my simulation and let's see how it's finished to work. Okay, we have parts replaced and job is done. So it's in this presentation, in this part, we've seen how we can use angular heads on 3-axis machine and on 5-axis machine as well to machine the features that cannot be machined by a regular 5-axis or 3-axis machine. Also, when we are talking about 3D cutters, we have to see how we are dealing with insert cutters. So in this case, I see this cutter was assembled for several inserts, and when we are making milling operation, I would like to see it in this revolved state. Same I can say about the drilling cutters with inserts and special tools what we see here that have some special feature for the milling, threading and internal cutting. So I see in milling job this operation should, this tool should look like revolved cutter. So how it looks like in our case? I will go to the operation, what I'm doing here, okay? I'm just rimming with turning head this all, and let's see how it looks like in operation. It's a classic rimmer, and when you're going to use this rimmer, we need to adjust this tool for particular diameter. And after I adjusted it, of course, this tool should be revolved and cut the part. So I'm going to simulate this operation in SolidCAM simulation. And what we see here is a revolved cutter. Let's make a hole. And if it will collide the material, of course, we will see. So to enable this functionality, we need to go to VimID, go to Working Style, Toolkit, and select Revolve Holders for Milling to Yes. Of course, it should be done with proper definition of joints, drive units, and proper tool assembly. We are not enabling this feature by default for our customers, and we recommend to talk with technical support before we start to use it. So let's switch to turning. And in turning, we have a special functionality was designed for machines that can measure the tool with inclined B-axis. And after it, only this position what we measured can be used in the operation. So in this case, we see NTX1000 machine, and I will open this machine in SolidCAM. And let's see what we have here. In toolkit we can see my 45 degrees holder. And if I want to use this holder on this machine, I have to measure the tool in this particular orientation. So it's mean I will mount the tool on the station and let's see how it looks like. I can measure this tool only if I rotate the axis to 45 degrees and orient it in this position. So once I define the cutting point for this tool, I can assign for it by the measure orientation the particular position how it's measured on. So for main spindle it can be like that, for back spindle it can be like that. So once I select this cutting point, only one possible orientation will be used for this operation. So let's go to the operation and see how it looks like. I'm going to operation number one and open the machine preview. In the machine preview, I see this orientation is used and no other orientation can be used for the operation. So if I want to use other orientation, I have to go to select other cutting point and use it for my operation. I will add a new cutting point and define for it 45 degrees angle, minus 45 degrees, okay. But I will not flip the orientation. So I will select this cutting point for the operation. And only one possible operation is allowed me for this operation now, okay. Of course, if I reverse my tool, only CCW direction for spinning can be used. So we are limiting you for CCW only. So if I want to change this orientation, I need to go to the tool table and select the proper cutting point again. This kind of working is reduced mistakes of the customers who define not possible position or orientation of tool for operation, but is not really measured on machine. So if your machine not support dynamic offsetting, you need to use this functionality and it will be much more safety for you. Okay, when we started to talk about turning, it's very important to talk about the nose point position. The first, we remember from previous versions, the nose point position was limited and not any point was able to use. So in SolidCAM 2021, I will back to my toolkit and open same tool. And let's see what the cutting point we can define here. So first, if I click to origin position, I can select any possible on the machine position if even I cannot measure it. Okay, so if I go here, this point can be measured on machine, but still you can select it for the reference. Of course, if you are not using and you're using default point, we will select for you the more usable point on the cutter. Also, when I look on this cutter, I can see it have not only one corner, it have four corners. So if you are picking origin position, we also allow you to switch to other corner on your cutter, even if it's not possible for this particular cutter. But theoretically, everything is possible, so we're not limiting you to use it. Of course, the nose point what is closest to your workpiece will be used by default, so you don't need to select it for every cutter. So how we seen, we have now complete freedom of nose point selection and also automatic recognition of radiuses and noses of the cutter. Okay, to enable this feature, what we talked in previous slide, limit the tool orientation for particular angle what we have in machine, we have a new parameter in VMID, and if you want to limit it, you need to set it to yes, so incline tool nose position. General controller should be defined as yes if your machine not support a fully dynamic nose point definition. Okay. So let's take a look on this particular tool table. So this tool table, what I see here, it looks different than tool table what we see in 3-axis machine. Why? Because when I go to the view, I have checked advanced view. You can enable it by pressing F9 or just unclicking it. So the by default you will get on most machines simple view. So simple view allow you to see the cutter structure, to see the preview. Also, when you go into machine preview, each time when you click on a cutter, it will automatically mount the cutter in the spindle. Same for rotary. Once I click on a cutter, the related holders with cutters, holder with cutter will automatically switch to the working position. If I go into advanced view, the behavior of it will be different. It still will work for rotary turrets. So when I switch to different station or different cutter, I see it's indexed to working position. But for the upper turret, it's, the behavior is different. So I will click on the tool, but the tool in the spindle is not changed. I need to do it manually by mounting the tool to the upper turret station 1. So the previously mounted tool is going to go to magazine and we have a new tool mounted. This behavior is more close to the machine reality, and if you need like a deep control of what you're doing on the machine, you can switch to advanced view and make everything manual. For this kind of machine, this advanced view is more useful. So if you want to use the advanced view in a tool table by default, you can go and set it in VimID, working style, toolkit, toolkit advanced view mode will open your tool table automatically in toolkit advanced mode every time when you open your toolkit. Otherwise, when you open it in when you switch into advanced mode, it will switch it back to the next open. So let's talk a little about the machine simulation. So first, the machine simulation structure was changed and improved. So today, when you're building a new machine, you don't need to define all items of under the station. You don't need edge holders stock. This machine structure will improve your loading and support on multi-body and multi-tool holders. So once we change it, and you can see here what's the difference, okay? This is a structure of machine simulation XML in 2020 version, and here is the 2021, and you see all this structure under the station is not needed anymore, and also all TH holders, adapters and stuff like this, we can remove it from simulation. So first, this structure reduces the loading time of simulation, less items, faster loading. It makes our XML really easy to read and edit, and enables to SolidCAM in the future to add new features to the tool item without involving the user and asking from support teams to change the machine structure. But also very important question, this structure will continue to work in SolidCAM 2021 as well. You don't need to change it if you don't want it. If you want to improve a little the loading time, and you can go and change it when you're building a new simulation, you can build it in a new structure and it will work fast and flexible. Additional feature what we have in SolidCon 2021 is support of health index targets. In this example, you can see has machine with 12 stations, but each station can be divided by 2. So we have like a health index turret as option, and you can use this type of holders that can hold 2 different tools with angle difference. So let's see it on real machine. I'll go and open Haas machine. Okay, and go to the tool table and let's see how the tool item is looks like. Here is tool number 1, but include inside 2 cutters. A first cutter, let's see it here, have 25 millimeter chunk and 55 degrees or 95 degrees chunk cutter. A second one have smaller chunk and 55 degrees cutter. So, but the difference between 2 cutters is 15 degrees. If I want to use the second cutter, I need to rotate my turret in additional 15 degrees relative to the station orientation. So, in this cutting point for this cutter, I can find the major orientation with minus 15 degrees delta from original station orientation. So let's see how it looks in operation. I will simulate few operations but using same tool in SolidCon simulation. And let's see how it looks like. First operation, I'm using my main tool. And the second operation, I'm using my secondary tool. And if I go to machine preview of this operation, I will see my orientation of turret is have additional 15 degrees here, and only in this orientation I can make a turning with this tool. To enable this functionality, you need to go to turret, rotary turret only, and enable the rotary turret interpolation functionality. Once you enable it, in the measurement position you will see the value of your track's axis, what you can add the delta for it. Of course, when we are talking about a new simulation, it's very important to mention the terraining simulation mode, because it's really connected to my presentation. I will go and show same operations, including the grooving, okay, in new simulator. So when I go to new simulator, I can see all simulation as regular 3D. But also, I can switch to the turning mode and see my simulation as we like to see it in classic SolidCon turning simulation. But little bit more power, because we see all holders in 3D, and you can see also the target geometry and updated stock geometry. If you're going to simulate same operation in old turning simulation, you will also can get a new feature. You see now the projection of this holder on the turning plane, and you will easily recognize collisions in case if it's happened, because you see your holder in 2D, but is projection of 3D holder. Now we will talk a little about Swiss type. We have additional presentations regarding Swiss type, so I will not go in deep on it. But I really want to mention this style of work, what we can do in 2021, which we are calling it modular machine setup. I will open this machine in SolidCon. Okay. So I just have a part without any jobs, but I will play only with tool table. And let's see what we have here. I will open the machine preview. Let's start from machine with tool preview. And let's see what how the tool item is looks like. So the tool item here include inside 5 different cutters. For this case, I can mount on this item 4 cutters for milling, or only one cutter, or group of cutters, or any other component that I can use on this machine by simple and easy assembly. So how it looks like on real machine, I'm going to machine preview, and we see all this assembly is already mounted, includes some cutters that user is using here, and we can see the proper position. If I will hide the tools from here, you see how this machine is looks without the cutters and how it looks with the cutters. So in one machine, we can make a lot of different configurations, add additional holders and special holders for turning, and exchange it between stations if the machine is allowed. It allows us to make our definition of Swiss type much more flexible and use less post-processors for several machine configurations. Just to see how is important, I will show you the difference between 2020 version and 2021, the VMID definition for exactly same machine. You see how many turrets you have to support these holders. And you see how many submachines you have to define to work with these turrets. And when you're going to 2021 version, you see we reduce the number of submachines to the really small amount, only logical ones, and only one turret is defined here. So today the definition of Swiss type machine becomes much more easier than previous version. Of course, it's hard to explain about a neutral table without talking about 3D tools and especially about small turning cutters. So in how you can see today, you can define even this very small solid cutting tool and see in the simulation and control the collisions and make all operations with this tool. I think it's really amazing. And when we start to talk about 3D tools, it's very important to say something about these shape turning tools. I will go and show you how it's work like. And let's open Integrex machine. And this Integrex machine, we are using it to cut with screwdriver. I can use also in my operations special cutter. Once I go here, I can see it. Okay. But generally designed to cut this particular shape of my cam part. So let's simulate it in new simulation. And now I can see it in turning mode, and let's see how it works like. Let's switch to default mode and see it again. Amazing. Just to impress you a little with abilities of and features of our simulations, I want to run one short part in a new simulation. So let's open the CAM part. In this short demonstration, I will show you how to cut this simple part, use it in Nuuk toolkit, so we can see all the assembly of tools with complex assemblies, multiple holders, multi-body holders, small tools, and 3D cutters, and also combine it with existing functionality of channel synchronization. So I go into the channel synchronization, and now we can see these operations are combined very well. So we almost don't have empty spaces and channels, so everything is working very productive. And also we can see everything happened in SolidCAM simulation. SolidCAM simulation today not supports multi-channel, but it do support balanced RAF operations. So we can see balanced RAF is making operation, and now we have finishing operation, and now we have like milling operation, and we continue to work on this part. At the end, it's very fast and nice done. I just want to run same part in machine simulation. So let's go to machine simulation. And first, I hope you will be impressed about the loading time of machine simulation. It's much faster, and it should take into account how many solids for tools are used inside. So with very complex holders on turret and for a milling spindle are used here, and it took few seconds to load it very fast. I will run this simulation and let's see how it's work like. So we see combined work of turning balanced roughing with very complex tools. A balanced roughing will finish the main spindle and switch to the back spindle. So we see now the different tools are working for. I can see any possible collisions because my definition of holders here is very, very precise. I see working with two channels simultaneously, finishing part, combining milling on both spindles and transferring part to the back spindle. So let's back a little. Drilling a part, removing my part from the back spindle, and make a transfer operation. Part is done. I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and thank you for watching.